Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. This is Mr. Faisal Rizdianto. Dear my student, this is the example of the assignment of making the video retelling the literary works. And now I'd like to deliver a presentation entitled The Interestingness of Harper Lee's To Kill a Mockingbird. It is a very famous novel in 1960s. It's a best-selling novel, and this is the only work of Harper Lee, yeah, and it is best-selling all over the world. American people say this is a must-read book before you die. Okay, why the title is Mockingbird? Yeah, Mockingbird is best known for the habit of some species mimicking the song of other birds and the sound of insects and amphibia. Mockingbird are able to sing 200 different songs. Killing mockingbird is considered sinful in American culture, since they never annoy human beings. They only sing and make happy everyone, and then make the world will be colorful. And the main characters, there are three: Atticus Finch, the wise father and lawyer, a widower, and then Scott Finch, 6-year-old daughter of Atticus. This is the point of view. Everything happened told by Scott Finch. And then Jim Finch, Scott's brother, who always helped Scott Finch when she got a quarrel with her friends. Okay, and the minor character, there are six characters. The first is Calpurnia, the African-American maid of Finch's family. She acts as a mother, as a mom for Scott and James. And sometimes she give advices, many advices to them. Okay, and then Dill Harris, Scott and James' best friend. Yeah, you can see on the right part. Yeah, and then the third is Arthur Bradley, a mysterious man always stay inside his house. Dill Harris, Scott and James always make fun of Arthur Bradley, the mysterious man. And then Tom Robinson, black man accused to try to rape Myla Ewell, a white girl. You can see on the bottom, this is Tom Robinson, yeah. And then Myla Ewell, a white girl. Actually, Tom Robinson is innocent. He is not doing anything bad to Myla. But Myla is a seductive and always influence, persuade Tom Robinson to make love of her. And then Bob Ewell, Myla's father, this one is responsible for doing bad things to the Finch family. Okay, dealing with the plot, yeah, we can see that at first Scott Finch lives in a sleepy Macomb, Alabama. Sleepy means that it is a very tiny or little town without nothing, no amusement, no facilities, yeah. And it is a time of in 1930 until 1960s, it is a Great Depression, a time of a chaotic socio-cultural economic condition in America. And racism still exists, so that, okay, after that I will describe. And the second, Scout Jim and Dill become obsessed with stories of Boo Radley. So this is a kind of children fantasy. Children want to find, or they are curious to find something mysterious. And then in Miss Mother's house burns down in winter, yeah. This is dealing with a chaotic condition. And then Boo secretly gives Scout a blanket. She get a kind of freak out. So this is a time when Boo Radley give to Scout, yeah. And then Atticus takes on Tom Robinson's Scout case and tries to defend him from the owls. Yeah, this is the heroic and the wise thing done by Atticus Finch. She is a white man, but he defend an innocent Tom Robinson's who is accused raping Myla Ewell. Yeah. And then the fifth things happen. The prejudiced jury convicts Tom. Though he is obviously innocent, he is shot while trying to escape from prison. So something bad happened that Tom Robinson is shot, yeah, even he is innocent. And then Bob Ewell, the dad, the father of Myla, still furious at Atticus, got angry to Atticus, attacks Jim and Scott in the woods at night. A mysterious stranger scares them and kills Mr. Ewell. The sheriff and all people thinks that it is Boo Radley who done it. And then the stranger was Boo Radley, who Scott now sees as a friend and protector. Yeah, the sheriff turns a blind eye to Boo's acts of murder. Scott walks Boo home. Okay, the essence of this story is that sometimes we have a prejudice to other people. Prejudice means that we think negatively. Yeah, in a cross-cultural understanding lecture, it deals with a kind of stereotype. Yeah. Stereotype means we think everybody with our own perspective. Yeah, like we say that Indian people are bad person, black men are bad person. So we always think another race, another community in our thinking. Yeah, in bahasa we can say orang Cina itu pelit, orang kulit hitam itu jahat, orang India itu suka menipu, ya, yeah, they always trick it, they always cheat us, blah blah blah. So, if we want to understand other people thinking, we should mingle with them, we should know them. So don't judge people by its cover. Don't think with our own perspective. So this is a very inspiring book. It will enhance. It will make us understand that life is not always black and white. Like Scott Finn say that when she is only 6 years old, she is able to understand that life is not black or white, and there is a gray area. So that this is a very inspiring book. I consider and I suggest you to read this book because it is very inspiring and it tells the reality of life. And it is in accordance with in Indonesia that in Indonesia there are many socio-cultural problems, sometimes prejudice among people, among race, among religion, blah, blah, blah. Okay, thank you very much for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.